One of the most exciting areas for intravenous ketamine therapy is within the realm of PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. There was an interesting study published by the American College of Neuropsychopharmacology in 2021. They were looking at patients who had PTSD and then using a type of special brain imaging called functional MRI. In this study, they were treating patients either with ketamine or midazolam. Midazolam is a benzodiazepine that was used as a placebo, and the ketamine was the active drug that was being studied. They took these patients and did analysis of what their brain was doing after they had received either the ketamine or the placebo midazolam. One of the interesting findings of the patients who had PTSD was there was inhibition of the amygdala by the prefrontal cortex. The prefrontal cortex is a portion of our brain that is responsible for kind of higher level thinking. So the patients who had PTSD, the activity of the amygdala seemed to be decreased. One of the things we know about the amygdala is that it is known as a fear processing center. So to summarize and bottom line it for you is that the ketamine seemed to decrease activity of the amygdala. And this is really cool because we're learning more and more about ketamine and how it can be used for patients who suffer from PTSD. As you may know already, PTSD can be really challenging to treat, and there's not a lot of drugs that are effective for it. So this is some cutting-edge research using functional MRI imaging of the brain to see what exactly is happening. Now, of course, these are preliminary studies, and we will truly never know exactly what is going on in our consciousness. But we get these clues, we get these hints by using the latest cutting edge science. So please let me know what you think about this. Leave me any questions or comments below, and I will see you next time.